Standard 7, Maths, 3rd chapter, Factorization. Before this, we saw how to factorize the numbers. Today, we are going to see how to factorize the numbers as well as find the prime factors of those numbers. The method is same. We will solve the examples. Suppose we will take, we have to compare two sums, two factors of two sums. For that, if we take a number 24 and 32, we have to factorize as I have showed you yesterday. Write it in this way. Then factorize it. Units place 4 is there. So you have to factorize it with the number 2. 2 ones are 2. 2 twos are 4. 2 six are 12. 2 threes are 6. 3 is a prime number. So 3 ones are. Got it? 32. In the units place 2 is there. So again 2 ones are 2. 1 remaining. 2 6 are 12. 2 8s are 16. 2 4s are 8. 2 2s are 4. 2 is a prime number. So 2 and 1. Okay. So we saw how to factorize this in previous video also. Till here we were able to solve it. Now one further step before this is, after this is 24, we have to write all the factors, that is 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Got it? And write the factors of 32 also. That is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Now we have to find the common factors. For that, circle the common factors. Got it? Only these many common factors are there. So, these numbers are said to be HCF, that is highest common factor of 24 and 32 is supposed to be 2 into 2 into 2, that is 8. Got it? We will solve one more example. This sum can be done in the horizontal way also. In the vertical way also, the one that is preferable to you, you can solve it. We'll take one more sum, that is 10, 15 and 12. Okay, so find the factors of 10 first, that is 2, 5's are 5, 1's are, that's it. Find the factors of 15, 5, 3's are 3, 1's are. Factors of 12, 2, 6's are, 2, 3's are, 3, 1's are. Got it? Now, we have to write the common factors. For that, you have to write all the numbers and then their common factors. 2, 2 into 3. Now, over here, there are no common divisors, right? There are no such common divisors. No common factors have been found. Therefore, we can write the HCF of 10, 15 and 12 is supposed to be 1. Got it? One more sum I'll explain you. If such three numbers have been given, we can solve it in a combined form. Suppose the number is 60, 12 and 36. These are the three numbers. Now how are you going to solve in one combined form? You have to form three vertical lines and write the numbers 16, 60, 12, 36. Got it? Now in the units place, the number is, even numbers are there. So you can write 2. 2 will be common for all the three numbers. So you don't have to solve it in a different way in this way. You can solve it all together in this way. Got it? So 2 threes are 6. 0 as it is. 2 sixes are 12. 2 ones are 2. 2 eights are 16. Again in the units place, even numbers are there, so you can take the number 2. So 2 ones are 2, carry this one. 2 5s are 10, 2 3s are 6, and 2 9s are 18. Now you will see 3, 9 and 15 are the multiples of 3. So you have to take the number 3. You have to think accordingly to the numbers that have been given. You have to change it accordingly, and all the numbers over here should be prime numbers. Over here they, you have to take only the prime numbers. So 3 5s are 15, 3 1s are 3, 3 3s are 9. Got it? Now you got 1 over here, so carry that 1 over here, or you can stop it over here as well. So you have got how many factors? You have got all the prime factors. So therefore, the HCF is 2 into 2 into 3, that is 2 into 2 into 3, that is 12. Got it? So you got the HCF. In the same way, you have to solve the exercise. Now, one more section is there, the division method. The division method for finding the HCF. This was the factorization method. This method is known as the factorization method. You can do it in this way, or you can do it in this way as well. Got it? The answer is going to be the same. One more method is there, that is division method. Suppose we take a number 144 and 252. The smallest number is to be taken outside, that is 144, 252. So this number is smaller, this number is greater. So you can take 144 multiplied by 1, that is 144. Got it? Now subtract this number. You will get 8, 0, 1. Okay, so again you have to subtract it with what number? That is 144. Got this? You have to take the 144 number. So again this number is smaller than this number. So 1s are 108. Got it? So again you have to subtract it. You will get the number 6 3 0, and what number you will take over here? 108. Got it? Now this number and this number, 108 and 36, 3s are 108. The answer is 0. You have to multiply in such a way that you get 0 at the end. Till that time you have to keep on dividing it. I'll explain you once more. The number was 144 and 252. You have to take smaller number and greater number over here. 144 multiplied by 1, that is 144. Subtract this, you get 108. 108 will be divided by 144. So you don't get 108. In 108 table you won't get 144. So you have to take 108. 1s are 108. Again subtract it, you will get 36. Take 108 as it is. 36 table you get 108. So 36 3s are 108, and at the end you get 0. Got it? Therefore, you will directly find the HCF of 144 and 252 is, what is the last number? 36. Got it? In this way you have to solve. We'll take one more sum. The number is 209 and 242. We'll again do the division sum. The number, smaller number is 209, the bigger number is 247. So you have to divide it with what? The number is almost equal to another. If you find 209 multiplied by 2, the number is going to be bigger. So you have to take 209. 1s are 209. When you subtract this, you will get 38. What number you will take over here? That is 209. Now 30, in 38's table, 209 is there or no? You have to check it by multiplying it in this way, and then The answer will be 38. 5s are 190. The number closer to this. Got it? You get the number closer to this. As we divide, we find the during division, as we find that the number closer to this number, we write it down. In the same way, we have to do it. Subtract it. You will get 19, and the number over here will be 38. 19, 2s are 38, and the answer will be 0. Therefore, HCF will be of 209, and 242 is supposed to be 19. Got it? In this way, you have to solve the example from the problem set 12. In the same way, find the HCF. For that, you have to use this method. This method or the combined one method, this one. And the next question is, in the second question, find the HCF by the division method and reduction of the simplest form. Now, what we did was division and the reduction of the simplest form. This method is supposed to be the division method. In the second question, you have to solve this. If you have any queries regarding these sums, you can mention it in the comment box. I'll try to answer your queries. Thank you.